Hi everybody, I'm Danny, and I'm a Senior Analytical Training Consultant here at SAS. Now, I'm here today with this video to talk about the similarities and differences between SAS Enterprise Guide and SAS Studio. Now, some of you have probably been using SAS Enterprise Guide, and you might have heard about SAS Studio. You might be asking yourself, hey Danny, what are the similarities and what are the differences if I wanted to try to start using SAS Studio? That's what this video is about today. So let's focus first on the similarities. If you use SAS Enterprise Guide, you know that you can write your own code, or you have the options of a graphical user interface that allows you to use tasks. And then SAS Enterprise Guide will write the code for you. Guess what? That's true in SAS Studio as well. You can just start writing code if that is what you so desire, or there are tasks, and you can use SAS Studio's graphical user interface to have it create the code for you. Once that code is done, both Enterprise Guide and Studio both allow you to make edits to the code. That's the similarities. But the question becomes, where are the differences? Join me. Let's check it out. So on my screen, as you can tell, I have SAS Enterprise Guide version 8 and SAS Studio present on the screen. Now, first things first, you can see that they're starting to look similar. That's because most recent versions of SAS Enterprise Guide and most recent versions of SAS Studio have been made to have the visualization look similar so that if anybody does want to move from Enterprise Guide to Studio, it looks a little bit of a cleaner move. Now, SAS Enterprise Guide, remember, is a separate program that is installed to be your interface into SAS. Now, if you notice, SAS Studio is in a browser. So with it being in a browser, it's part of the installation of SAS itself, but it's not a separate application program that has to be installed. Okay, so that's one major difference that we have. Now, the second thing is the task part. Now, there are possibly more tasks and will be more tasks in the SAS Studio area than there are in the Enterprise Guide area. Let me just show you really quick. If you look over here inside of SAS Enterprise Guide and I go to the task area, you probably recognize that list that you see down there at the bottom. And those are the different tasks that are built into SAS Enterprise Guide to allow you to actually get some work done. Now, if I were to go over into SAS Studio and bring back my left panel here, here are all of the tasks there. Note the differences in the amounts. So yes, there will be more tasks inside of the SAS Studio territory than there are in the Enterprise Guide territory. But that's not the main thing about the tasks that I want to talk about. There are common tasks, for example, linear regression, that appear both in SAS Enterprise Guide and in SAS Studio. But here's the differentiation. SAS Studio actually brings in its task the ability to use more current procedures. For example, have you ever heard of GLMSELECT? Anybody? Well, if you haven't, it's a newer, I won't say brand new because it's been around for a little while, but it is a newer procedure that will allow you to do linear regression, specifically variable selection techniques inside of your linear regression. Think forward, backward, and stepwise, if that rings a bell. Now, let me just show you this. So I've already got a process flow ready to go. The data set that I'm using in both of these examples is the baseball data set, and it's in the SASHELP area, and you have that on your machine already. So feel free to play around with that data set if that's of an interest to you. Now, I've got a linear regression task already set up. I'm going to ask it to modify. I've got my salary as a dependent variable. I've got the number of hits, the number of home runs, and the number of runs as my predictor variables. Now, if I actually go into the model territory and I focus my idea here on the model selection methods and I move that drop-down arrow, do you see the choices that I have? Those are very specific types. Well, that's because those are the ones that proc reg will allow me to perform. Now, I've got the same thing over here in Studio. Okay, so let me get rid of that left panel, just give me a little bit more room. Here is my task in SAS Studio. And right here is my model selection territory, forward selection. Notice I have the choice of forward, backward, and stepwise, but look at how we can decide whether to add or remove the variables. Do you see that I've got a lot more choices here? And that is because GLMSELECT is now a possible procedure that can be utilized. Case in point, look right here at the actual code that is being written by SAS Studio. There's GLMSELECT and procreg. So again, in both of those cases, in this case, I actually have GLMSELECT and more options to deal with. Speaking of code, do you see how I can see the code immediately right here in SAS Studio? That's an option because of this split up at the top. Remember in Enterprise Guide what I had to do to get to the code? Remember this preview code button down at the bottom? Then I could edit the code possibly if I do the custom insertions, but I only had certain places that I could actually put code in. Do you remember what you had to do to actually get to full code to be able to edit? You have to save this, and then you have to basically create it as a code template to open it actually itself, to actually get into code territories and things like that inside of Enterprise Guide. Over here in SAS Studio, all you have is the edit button. Once you hit the edit button, that code pops out immediately, and then everything is ready and raring to go. Well, that concludes the video for today, everybody. Hope you greatly enjoyed it. Hope you learned something. And don't forget, we love to hear from you guys. So if you have a comment, if you have a question, if you have an idea for a future video, drop it in the comments below. And as always, don't forget, if you really like our content here and you would like to see more, don't forget to give us a subscribe. We'd appreciate it. Take care.